Hello everyone! In this video, I'll show you how to install and configure RoundCube Webmail, together with Postfix and Dovecot. This setup will give you a complete and professional mail system that you can access directly from your browser, with a user-friendly interface. Before getting started, make sure that your mail server is running stably. SSL TLS is already configured. The LAMP stack is installed, and a subdomain for Webmail is available. First, we'll create a subdomain specifically for Webmail. You can choose any name you like. Next, create an A record in your domain's DNS management panel. In the name field, enter the subdomain you just created. In the value or IP address field, enter the IP address of your mail server. After saving, wait a few minutes for DNS propagation. Then try pinging the subdomain to make sure it points correctly to your server's IP address. Next, we need to install some required PHP extensions so that RoundCube Webmail can run properly. These extensions provide support for database connections, encryption, and email-related functions. Next, we'll create a database for RoundCube Webmail. First, log in to MariaDB or MySQL using the root account. Next, we will create the database name, database user, and database password based on the template I've prepared. Just replace them with your own information to use with RoundCube Webmail. Next, we'll download RoundCube Webmail from the official website to make sure we're using the latest and most secure version. First, navigate to the root directory of your web server. Next, visit the official RoundCube website. Here, you can choose the stable, latest or LTS version of RoundCube. In this example, I will select the LTS version to ensure long-term stability. After downloading, let's extract the RoundCube package we just downloaded. After extracting, rename the folder to any name you prefer for easier management and access later. Next, set the correct permissions for the RoundCube directory so that the web server can properly read and write the required data. Next, we will create a virtual host for RoundCube Webmail so that it can be accessed using the subdomain you configured earlier. After that, we will add the sample configuration content into the virtual host file we just created. Make sure to replace the subdomain and folder name with your own information, so the virtual host points correctly to the RoundCube Webmail installation. Next, enable the virtual host you just created and restart your web server to apply the new configuration. Now, open your browser and go to the subdomain you configured for RoundCube Webmail. Make sure that on the RoundCube installation page, all environment checks and PHP extensions show OK status. If any item is marked as an error or warning, you should fix it before proceeding with the installation. Here, enter a description name for your service. You can choose any name you like. In the Database Setup section, enter the database information you created in Step 3, including database name, database user, and database password. This will allow RoundCube to connect and store its data. Next, in the IMAP settings section, enter the full host name of your mail server that you configured earlier. Use port 993 for the IMAP's connection, which is the secure port we previously set up for Dovecot. Next, in the SMTP settings section, enter the full host name of your mail server, the same as in the IMAP configuration. Use port 587 for the SMTP connection with STARTTLS, which is the secure submission port we configured in Postfix. Next, choose the default display language for the entire RoundCube Webmail system if you wish. In the plugin section, you can choose to install additional extensions if you like. This allows RoundCube Webmail to have extra features depending on your needs. Finally, click the Create Config button to complete the installation. Once the configuration has been saved, click Continue to move on to the next step. Next, click the Initialize Database button to let RoundCube automatically create the required tables in the database you configured. If the process is successful, you will see a confirmation message that the database has been initialized successfully. Next, to make sure everything is working properly, test logging in to RoundCube Webmail using the email account you created in Postfix and Dovecot. If you can log in and send/receive emails successfully, it means the system has been configured correctly. In the same way, test the IMAP config to ensure the connection to the Dovecot server is working properly. If everything is correct, you will be able to log in and view your mailbox directly in RoundCube. At this point, you can now start using RoundCube Webmail. Simply visit the subdomain you configured and log in with your email account to begin using the system. We have successfully logged in to the RoundCube Webmail interface. However, as you can see, the email address is not displayed correctly. To fix this issue, you need to make a small adjustment in the Dovecot configuration file. Add this configuration line into the Dovecot file so that the system only takes the username and automatically attaches it to the domain you configured. You also need to make a small adjustment in the RoundCube Webmail configuration file. Add these two configuration lines at the end of the RoundCube Webmail configuration file. Don't forget to replace it with your actual domain name to make the configuration work correctly. Once you've made the changes, restart the Apache and Dovecot services to apply the new configuration. Now, go back to RoundCube Webmail to check. Once you've logged in successfully, you will see that the system correctly recognizes your email address in the proper format. In addition, your connection is currently showing as not secure. To keep users safe and protect login information, we will configure free SSL with Let's Encrypt for this webmail subdomain. First, install Certbot and its required components if they are not already installed on your server. Next, run the Certbot command to issue an SSL certificate for your webmail subdomain. If the installation is successful, you will see a confirmation that the certificate has been issued and applied to your webmail subdomain. Next, restart Apache to apply the recent changes. Now try accessing it again, using HTTPS. Your browser should display a secure connection with a padlock icon, instead of the previous not secure warning. That's it! We've successfully installed and configured RoundCube Webmail with Postfix, Dovecot, and free SSL from Let's Encrypt. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. And if possible, click Super Thanks to support me even more.